Welcome to Pilgrim Congregational Church, United Church of Christ. We are in Lexington, but you are all over the place, and we are so glad that you are with us today. This is a Zoom worship service, and we are moving towards hybrid this summer, so we're excited that on July 4th, we will be both in person and on the Zoom. I want to let you know that today's service is recorded, as always, so that we can post to our website, and we are putting worship links in the chat right now so that you can bring up your bulletin. Please add your joys and concerns to the chat. It's been quite a week in our congregation and in the world, and we want to include everyone's prayers with our prayers today. And I believe those are our Zoom orientation announcements, although we do suggest that you turn off your mic unless you're speaking and that you go ahead and use speaker view in the Zoom. That will give you a slightly better view of all that is going on. Now, Dot is going to introduce and then share with you our prelude. So Dot, I'm going to spotlight you and let you introduce things.
This morning's prelude is a setting of Psalm 34, Taste and See the Goodness of the Lord. Put together, and I'm sorry to say this, but I hope this is our last virtual ensemble so that next fall we can go into a real ensemble.
Hi, Matt. Say that again. Sorry, we're grabbing ourselves.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's all on the... Share sound.
Folks, give us just 1 second. We're going to work this through. Someone heard it and someone didn't? Okay. Y'all, this is worth it. We are, okay, Jeff heard it. Just give us 1 second. We're going to see if we can figure this out. Dot, I'm going to try to share it myself. No, that's not the one. Folks, technical difficulties, please stand by. This is what happens when I get in late in the evening. So just give me 1 second. Is it in the audio folder, Dot? I don't think it is, actually. Okay, hold on. I'm going to see if I can share it, and please put in the chat if you are able to hear this one, okay? So just 1 second. Thank you.
Good morning and welcome to Pilgrim Church. We are an open and affirming church, and we are so glad that you are all here with us today. We have a few announcements today. One is that it is Race Amity today at 1 p.m. We also have a hymn sing next Sunday, so send in your requests for that. You can do it through the chat, or you can send an email, respond to the e-notes works too. Also, summer worship is going to start July 4th at 9:30, and we will need some help setting up chairs and tents outside for communion Sundays. So if you'd like to volunteer, please let us know. Also, Sunday school and confirmation has ended. We will continue back up in the fall, but we will have some in-person meetups throughout the summer. So keep an eye out on your emails if you have some kids or youth. Now, please join me and Pastor Reebee in the call to worship.
Come and give thanks to our God. Sing praises to God's holy name.
With the melody of the lute and the harp and the song in our hearts, we declare God's steadfast love in the morning and faithfulness at night.
God's works make us glad.
Your works are great, O God. We sing our praises of joy to you. And here our opening prayer. O God, maker of all that is beautiful, Jesus gave us the seeds of your justice and peace. In this time together, touch us, teach us, and inspire us to sow those seeds through our ministries so that all may share in creation's abundance to make true the promise that no one will know scarcity and no one will suffer deprivation in this community and beyond. Amen.
So, friends, It is Special Music Sunday, and we really want to highlight the beauty of the music of our congregation today. And in addition to that, we are electing our officers and praying for our church council today. But I do have a little word, a brief word, to share with you today, beginning with our scripture reading. And our scripture reading comes from the Gospel according to Mark, chapter 4, 26 to 32. In the Gospel of Mark, this is the beginning of Jesus' teaching in parables. And these two are familiar, but maybe they're a little different in the Gospel of Mark than they are in the other synoptic Gospels. I hope you will listen to these two parables with fresh ears for the wisdom that God has for you today. Jesus also said, "The kingdom of God is as if someone would scatter seed on the ground and would sleep and rise night and day, and the seed would sprout and grow, and he does not know how. The earth produces of itself first the stalk and then the head and then the full grain of the head. But when the grain is ripe, at once he goes in with his sickle, because the harvest has come." Jesus also said, "With what can we compare the kingdom of God? Or what parable will we use for it? It is like a mustard seed, which when sown upon the ground is the smallest of all seeds on the earth, yet when it is sown, it grows up and becomes the greatest of all shrubs. It puts forth large branches so that the birds of the air can make nests in its shade." Here ends the reading from the Gospel of Mark. May God add a blessing to this word. And Sarah now has a word for our kids and everybody.
Hello. So has anybody seen a really big tree? Think of the biggest tree you've ever seen. Whenever I see a really big tree, I can't help but think about how long it's been growing. And usually when you see a really big tree, it's been growing a really long time. Did you know that sequoia trees, which can grow up to 350 feet tall, have been thought to have lived for more than 2,000 years? Isn't that amazing? That means that some of those trees that we can see today were on earth while Jesus was alive. The other neat thing about seeing really giant trees is to think that something that big grew from just one tiny little seed. One little thing turned into a very big thing. In today's scripture reading, Jesus tells a parable about the kingdom of God. And he talks about how it's kind of like a tiny seed that grows into something much bigger than itself. That's an important lesson for us Christians. We can never know when our small acts of kindness, lending a helping hand to someone in need, or maybe even just sharing a smile, can grow into something very big and important. You may not even know how much your kindness, how much of a difference your kindness made in someone else's life. So this week, I want you to remember Jesus's story and plant the seeds of love and caring. See how many times you can plant kindness seeds this week. Deal? Let's pray. Dear God, we know that our love and kindness are like seeds that grow into the hearts of those who we meet. Help us to spread your love during the week ahead. Amen.
Our video today is John Rutter's I Will Sing with the Spirit, and this is the choir's final performance of the pandemic season. And I'd just like to say thank you very much to all the members of the choir. Thank you very much to Duncan, and thank you very much to Elena for helping me put the video together. And Dot for all of her wonderful accompanying and musical skills this year, and being a very supportive colleague through all of this craziness that we went through. So once again, I might as well thank Reebee and Sarah too, because they're awesome. So once again, thank you everybody for the great choir season. And we really hope that we're back to normal next year. So have a great summer and thank you.
Y'all, this would be the moment when we would applaud for the choir, because that is just beautiful. And we thank everyone in the choir. And I want to now actually call on Susan Carabio, our moderator, who is going to offer a little word. Susan.
Hi, good morning, everybody. That was amazing. I am so excited that I'm looking forward to us being back in the building and being back in the space with everybody. But I want to say thank you very much to Dot and to Max and everybody for the music program and what you navigated through this past year. You should probably write a book about what you did. And also thank you very much to Duncan and everybody else with technical assistance. Just really wonderful. And the music is very soothing and calming and meaningful to all of us. So thank you very, very much, as well as thank you, Reebee, for all your help. So thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Susan.
Do you all want to say anything else, either Max or Dot or Elena? Okay. Well, thank you all. This is what a blessing our music program has been to all of us. And I think at this point with our recordings, we have like a video album that, you know, a full album of extraordinary audio and video music from this year. It has gotten us through. It has gotten us through. Friends, would you pray with me? Oh God, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts together be always acceptable in your sight, for you are our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Well, today I just have a relatively brief word about the mustard seed that I want to share with you. Parables are these neat little stories with punchy endings, right? The parable of the Good Samaritan means take care of your neighbors. They're all your neighbors, even the least, the lost, and the outsider. The parable of the prodigal son, God will never, ever, ever stop loving you, might be one straightforward meaning. Well, it actually turns out that most of the parables of Jesus are a little bit more like Zen koans in the Buddhist tradition, short passages with multiple or paradoxical meanings that require you to really think deeply. Right after this morning's parables, in fact, Mark's gospel tells us that there's more to Jesus's teachings than these few sentences, but that only some people in Jesus' moment had access. With many such parables, he spoke the word to them as they were able to hear it. He did not speak to them except in parables, but he explained everything in private to his disciples. It would be handy to wrap these two parables in Mark up in a well-formed bow. You know, God's grace abounds even in unexpected places. Plant a tiny seed and watch for God to turn it into something enormous. The church may be a tiny seed now, but through God's abounding grace, it will grow into something enormous. And those are good interpretations. But there are some paradoxes that are built in to this parable in the Gospel of Mark, because the mustard seeds in the ancient Near East did not need to be sown into the ground. They were weeds. They didn't grow into beautiful plants or into strong trees. They grew into weedy shrubs like the one I'm going to show you here. Now, obviously, this was not a picture taken in Jesus' day, but someone was dressing as Jesus might have, showing this big, bushy shrub. The authors who posted this image asked the questions, why would you plant a weed? Why would you want it to grow into this huge shrub with branches? Why would you want birds in your field or garden? In other words, what good does it do to give over space in your land to a plant that you cannot eat, to give shelter for creatures that you can't eat either? So that's one paradox. And another paradox is this: why would Jesus say that the kingdom, the basileia of God is like this weedy bush? Which, by the way, brings me to a weed that has had in the past a bad reputation in these parts. A weed whose scientific name is based on the Greek god of medicine. A weed that if you boil it properly, you can eat it, but don't eat it raw. If you know what you're doing with it, you can use the sap to remove warts, a weed that indigenous people used to treat lung diseases, a weed that feeds 450 different species of insects. If you have guessed what I'm talking about, go ahead and put your guess in the chat. This is a weed whose seeds travel around like dandelion seeds, but it's not a dandelion. The seeds themselves are so fluffy that they were actually used to make makeshift life jackets in World War II. And they were credited with saving many human lives. And yet, because it self-propagates, like the seed of the first part of our passage this morning, we call it a weed. And for decades, people did their best to remove it from the landscape. And industrial agriculture has pretty much wiped it out in the Midwest as well. It turns out that it's pretty easy to get rid of with herbicides. So if you're sowing thousands of acres of soy or corn, you don't have to put up with this weed. You can get rid of it. But now we've come to understand what removing milkweed means. Without milkweed, a major fraction of monarch butterflies cannot live. This strange, ugly to some, self-propagating weed is the food that monarch caterpillars depend on. So milkweed, and this is good news, is regaining popularity and appreciation. And that is wonderful because the monarchs really need help. A plant that we used to discount completely is now a treasured part of biodiversity. This picture, by the way, I took 2 days ago in Tennessee. Debbie Thomas brings this back to the mustard seed when she asks, so what is Jesus saying when he describes the sacred and the holy as a tiny, insignificant mustard seed? What does it mean to take an invasive, spindly weed, a plant we would sooner discard than sow, and make it the very heart, the very structural center of God's kingdom? Who and what counts in God's economy? What is beautiful? Who matters? Where do we find the sacred? The kingdom of God is all about welcoming the unwelcome, sheltering the unwanted, practicing radical inclusion. The garden of God does not exist for itself. It exists to offer hospitality to everyone that the world deems unworthy. It exists to attract and house the very people that we might rather shun. So maybe then today's parables really do have a clear point. And maybe it's the same one, the very same one as the Good Samaritan and the prodigal son. Take care of your neighbors, and they are all your neighbors, even the least, even the lost, even the outsider, even the weed, even the birds who rest in the branches of an ugly shrub, even you, even me. God will never, ever, ever, ever stop loving us. So we might as well throw mustard seeds all over the place and see what the harvest might bring. And see what beautiful butterflies land in our midst. Amen. So now, friends, we turn now to our peace. And I'm going to invite you to, if you are quick on your feet, put it in gallery view so that you can see all these boxes and people near us. And I'm going to invite you to put your hands first towards your camera to offer a blessing of peace to every single person in this congregation. And then I want you to put your hands up here next to the next boxes next to you and offer a prayer, if you will, to whoever's hands you are about to touch. I am about to touch, I think, Fran and Bob, and I wish peace to Fran and Bob. Think about who you are almost touching with your hands in the Zoom boxes and offer a prayer of peace to each one of them. Peace be with you. May the peace of Christ be with all of you. Amen. And now we are going to sing Joyful, Joyful, and Max and Elena are going to lead us in that. You all. And indeed, our prayer time starts with some joys this week. If you have an additional joy or concern that you want to put into the chat, I invite you to do that like right now so that we can include them in our prayers. And if they don't get into the spoken prayers, we will all hold them together, the things that we read together in the chat. I want to share with you all the joys that Trevor John was born this week in Sarah Jane's family, and he is healthy and they are doing well. So that is, we congratulate Nancy and Sarah Jane and everyone in that family. And there is joy with the travel this week. I give thanks for a great trip to Tennessee and having gotten back safely. Hallelujah, thanks be to God. And we pray for traveling mercies for Lisa and Jeff as they go to see Lisa's mom. And we give thanks for music. We give thanks on this special Music Sunday that even through a pandemic, y'all, this congregation made music together. That is good. And how exciting that maybe in the fall we get to make music together in person. We hope, we pray. We also hold so much that we are grieving, people that we are missing, people that have passed away in the midst of COVID or from COVID. We pray today as those who loved Martha Kimball are grieving her loss. We know that she is at peace now, and we give thanks that her family surrounded her with such love and peace and comfort in her final days. And we pray for them in their grief. We pray for those who are sick and for those who are in need of peace and courage. For Ted, after surgery on his vocal cords and dealing with Parkinson's. We pray for George, who has been back in the hospital, Deborah's father. We pray for his continued healing and rebuilding of his independence. We pray for Jane in her continued transition to assisted living. We pray for Gail and everyone who has cancer. We pray for healing and for hope. And with that beautiful hymn in our ears still, and with the words of scripture reminding us of the extraordinary power of nature, we pray. And I offer this prayer from Rachel Hackenberg, a UCC pastor, inspired by those parables. Oh God, for each seed of tenderness, we are grateful. For each planting of joy, we give you thanks. For each seed of wonder, we sing gratitude. For each planting of patience, we give praise. For each seed of love, we lift up your name. For each planting of faith, we offer our joy. For each seed of healing and courage, we give thanks. Let each seed be a blessing, a sign, a parable of your reign. And we pray this all in the name of Jesus, who taught us this prayer, which holds all prayers in one. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
And now it is time for our offering. As always, we're so grateful for all of the gifts you support the church and its ministries through. There's always a few ways to give your offering to the church. One is through the website. There should be a link in the chat. Also, you can send in a check or set up electronic giving with Dave McClave.
And now we will have our offertory music.
Our offering today is Total Praise by Richard Small.
Please join me now in the prayer of dedication. You have been exceedingly generous to us, O God. We return a portion of what we have to you in grateful thanksgiving. Bless our offerings that they will nurture the seeds of hope and healing in this community and beyond. Amen.
Friends, I want to let you know that we are going to have the very briefest of congregational meetings right now. Susan is going to lead us through that. Duncan is going to be our clerk pro tem. We need to officially vote in our officers, and then I will pray for our officers and our council. This is going to be quick. So Susan, I hope that you, and then we will have like the fabulous postlude from Dot Bo, by the way. So don't tune out yet. Susan, take it away.
Wonderful. Thank you again. So good morning, everybody. I just wanted to highlight, and first of all, I'd like to say thank you very much to the council members who are just do such a fabulous job going into this upcoming year. I would like to present the proposed leaders of the church working alongside, obviously, with Reebee and the staff. From moderator would be myself. Ed Bond, who I don't believe is joining us today as he is away, will be the proposed assistant moderator. And then we have Nick Zorn, who has agreed to continue on as our clerk. So what we would like to ask from all of you is to have a vote from our members. We can do this a couple of different ways. It would be wonderful if you are able to type into the chat. If you are unable to do that, we would also ask that you can unmute yourselves to vote. We'll be voting yes, no, or abstaining. If I could turn this over to Duncan. Let's see, where's Duncan here? If you could assist with that vote, that would be fantastic.
Happy to do so.
Thank you. So if I could ask all of you, we'd like to have this vote. So all in favor, if you can say yes, no, or abstain. And if you're not able to, again, type into the chat, we're going to be recording this to make this a little easier for Duncan. You can unmute yourselves if you're unable to type in, please.
And if there are two members of your household, please have each of them indicate in the chat. So you might say, Zach, yes, John, yes, as an example.
Okay. Yes for Michael.
Yes.
Yes for Sandy.
Yes for Deborah.
Yes for Mary.
Yes to Patricia.
Yes from San May.
I don't know what to do next.
I'll put that down as a yes, Jim.
Oh, you've got it. Okay.
I'll put it down as a yes for Barbara and Jim.
All right, thank you. I don't know what to do next on this stupid thing.
You've done it. Thank you.
You've done it. And I see that our some of our confirmands have voted, and that is great. Yeah, good. Duncan, when you feel the process is complete, let me know.
I think I've recorded everything that has happened so far.
Okay. I'm going to save the chat, and then we will send that off to you for the official record later. And now the last part of this meeting is that we are going to pray. And this is a prayer that is not just for our officers, Susan, Ed, Dave, and Nick. And Dick points out, did we also vote for treasurer? And Dave, yes. So please, if you have any concern about your vote having been cast for all four of those officers, speak now or type into the chat. That did include Dave McClave, our treasurer. The reason that we're doing this in worship is because this is a prayerful moment in our church, and we want to pray for not just Susan, our moderator, Ed, our assistant moderator, Dave, our treasurer, Nick, our clerk, but for every member of council, for Marge and for Duncan, for Mary and for Jeff, for Doug and for Dick and for Bob. And I'm hoping that plus our officers, that gives us what our council is comprised of. And we want to bless you all in your work as leaders of our church. So I invite you all to pray with me. Council members, you have been called by this church to lead, and you have been graced by God with the skills that this church needs for leadership. This ministry is a blessing and a responsibility. It recognizes your special gifts and calls you to your work among us. We thank you for accepting your obligation to this good work, and we challenge you to do your best on behalf, not just of this church, but in service to our neighbors and in service to God. So we pray, Almighty God, pour out your blessings upon your servant leaders who have been given these particular ministries in your church. Strengthen them, give them wisdom, give them compassion, give them courage. Grant them grace to give themselves wholeheartedly to your service. Keep before them the example of your gospel. Give them the strength and the hope that they need in this time of leadership, and reward their faithfulness with the knowledge that through their work and our work together, we have indeed served you with faithfulness. And for the congregation, we pray that every member of this congregation and every friend of this congregation and every visitor of this congregation would support and bless and encourage the work of our council. Speak the truth with love to them so that they may do this good work and answer when they call. And all this we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Probably officially we have to end the meeting, so my guess is no one's going to object to that, but if you object to ending the meeting and singing Precious Lord, then please let me know. otherwise, we will move into Precious Lord and the benediction and postlude and coffee hour. Amen. Friends, go in love, for love alone endures. Go in peace, for it is the gift of God. Go in safety, for we cannot go where God is not. Amen. Now Dot will offer us the postlude. a great postlude to end Special Music Sunday. And I'm going to go ahead and turn off the recording now. And you can unmute yourselves and greet one another for coffee hour.